Hi, it's Michelle, and I'm doing a video here about the unboxing and setup of my new Dropcam. And I usually don't get why people do these unboxing things, but the reason why I'm doing it here is because the first one I ordered, I wasn't really paying attention to how it was wrapped and all that when I set it up. And as it turned out, when I finally plugged it into the AC power, it wouldn't work. It worked when it was plugged into my computer, but it didn't work when it was plugged into the wall. And it turned out all it was the little AC cube was defective, I guess. Anyway, so here's how it comes. So this is the second one I got, and I ordered it next day for $3.99. If you have Amazon Prime, you get $3.99, you can get it quicker. So I kind of regret that because I've done that twice now, and both times I just got the feeling that maybe I got something refurbished or that had been returned. So now, from now on, I'm waiting the 2 days. So here's what's in the box. The camera, and it's got this little hello sticker on it. I guess that's to protect the lens. And then it's got, that's the little thing you attach to the wall. I guess a wall mount thing and some instructions, I guess. I don't think I read those because I haven't attached it to the wall yet. And then here is the power cord. It's a USB, mini USB cord. It connects to your computer to set it up, and then it connects to the AC. So that last little packet was just some silicone stuff to keep the moisture out, and that is the screws and the little drywall support things. Here's the AC thing, and that the little leg things pop out, and it's got a USB thing, almost like an iPod or something. I was going to measure that AC cord for you because it is pretty long, but I kind of wanted to give you an idea of how long it really takes to get this all set up, so I was trying not to get sidetracked, as I often do. Okay, so you pull this little plastic thing off of the camera, and the only thing different that I see, that I remember about this looking newer maybe than the defective one I got, was that this had two of these little wire wraps on the cord, whereas the other one had one. Everything else I remember being just about the same. So let's see. Having a USB cord is that you potentially or hypothetically you could plug it into like a USB battery pack if you didn't want to connect it to an electrical outlet. Anyway, so here's my biggest complaint. I think this is really, they need to put a sticker or something on this because this is very, very confusing. This little mini USB port that goes in here, usually it's really obvious which way's up and which way's down, but on this one, for some reason, it is not obvious at all. And you have to look really, I mean, I put it under a magnifying glass to try to figure out on the first one which way it goes, because you don't want to force it in there and then have a broken product before you even start. So that's why I'm zooming in on this and showing you that it's not all that intuitive. This little B is facing upwards, and it really doesn't even look like it's plugged in all the way. There you go. See, you can see some of the metal there, and the other side says Dropcam, I think, on it, and you would think that that would go upwards towards the other Dropcam, but I don't think it does because my camera's working now. But just be really careful about that, and that's the way mine inserted into there. Okay, so now I've plugged it into my computer, and it's supposed to just launch right into it, but mine didn't. So what I had to do was go to the Start menu, go to Computer, and then I was able to see this Dropcam, and I clicked on that. So I click on Setup Dropcam. This brings me to an option for Mac or Windows. I'm on a Windows 7 computer, so I'm going to click on Setup Dropcam Windows, which will then launch what was supposed to launch automatically. And it didn't launch this way with either the first one I tried to install or this one. So this is what you should have seen when you first plugged your Dropcam into your computer. I don't need to create a username and password because I've done it once already. So my computer's remembering that, and I'm logging in. And now it's looking for Wi-Fi networks. It's going to show my neighbors and mine. And here I'm entering the password for the Wi-Fi network. Hopefully you remember that. Hopefully you have a Wi-Fi. You better have a Wi-Fi password. If not, I wouldn't be connecting this if I were you. Connect to Wi-Fi. Now, it really does take just this long. I'm not cutting out any video here because I want you to see how long it really takes. That's why I'm talking so fast. Okay, so it's connected to the Wi-Fi, and on the next screen it's going to tell you to where some information about where to set the camera. So click that little box and click next. The setup really is this fast. I cut out about 2 minutes in the section where it tells you to disconnect from your computer and plug it into the wall and put the camera where you want it, because I didn't think you wanted to stare at the screen for 2 minutes. So I've taken my camera to the window facing my front door and set it up inside the house but facing outside, so I can see out the front door and towards the street. And then I come back to my computer and click next. And then you're going to name your camera. Mine is facing the front entry, so I'm going to name it entry and click watch now. I may actually set this up outside as a front door intercom because my front porch is covered, but I'm not going to do that right now. So here is my front entry, and there is the Amazon box with the camera where the AC didn't work, so that one's going back. And this is the kind of thing that I actually got the camera for, so I can watch who's coming to my door. I can see when UPS comes. You're going to click on the settings up here to bring up settings for this camera. It's called entry because that's what I named it. I want the status lights off because I don't want a yellow light calling attention to the camera. The night vision works really good, but I don't want it in this camera right now. It shines some red lights. I want the audio off because it's indoors facing outdoors, so I don't want to pick up all the audio from inside my house. And I want to detect motion events, which will send me an alert when somebody's coming to the front door or comes and knocks on my front door or snatches a box off of my front doorstep. I don't want the sound. So when you click this close button up here, that is the same as clicking save, and now it's going to apply those settings that I just set. So now I want to go back into my settings and set up what kind of alerts I want to get. I've already told it about what I want to detect, and that has to do what it's going to, how it's going to save your history, how it's going to put like markings in the history to call your attention to certain things. But now I want to set alerts, and that's when I'm going to get a message to either my iPad, phone, or an email telling me if it's been unplugged, if the electricity to it's gone out, if it's detected motion, if it's detected sound. You may want to turn off motion alerts if your camera's facing the street and you don't want to get an alert every time a car drives by your house. You can also use the sharing screen to send a message to somebody else that you want to be able to view the camera. Now this is really important. Do not check this. Do not make your camera public unless you want the whole world to be able to watch what your camera is picking up. If you have a puppy cam or a kitty cam, that could be like a pretty neat little live streaming thing to embed in your website. That would be a pretty neat use for this camera. But if you're using it for home security, you definitely do not want to make that public. Now this is just going back. I only have 5 minutes of history here since it's only been plugged in for 5 minutes. But I'm just showing you what some of your viewing options are to go back in history. You can go back 30 seconds or you can go back in this timeline. Live streaming is free and you have 14 days to try out the cloud services where it's going to save 7 days of history. You can also save up to 30 days of history if you're willing to pay a little more. But you don't have to do this. It's not saving it to your hard drive. It's saving it to a drive in the cloud or live streaming. So those are your options there. All of this looks different on an iPad, an iPhone, or your computer. I really like the way it looks on the iPad. So I would give this product a thumbs up for ease of setup. It's quick, it's very easy, and it's a great product. For $149, I think it's a keeper. If you found this video interesting or helpful, please take a moment to thumbs up, subscribe to my channel, or make a comment. Thanks for watching.